use your position in Hollywood to make a difference, like this event tonight?
Well, you can, it's certainly one way, it's not the only way, but it's, I've done 4 charity events this year alone, and I've raised money for teaching, I've raised money for anti-drug programs, I've raised money for diseases, I've raised money for a hospital, and this is my 4th of the year. So it's, you know, it's not just a question of showing up, you have to call people because times are more difficult, there's a recession, and so you have to really pick up the phone and call people and use your relationships and contacts to persuade people to buy tables. And that's the responsibility you take on when you agree. The honor is less important than obviously than the cure of the disease and the impact that it has.
So how have you reached your position today?
A very long crawl up the ladder, you know. I mean, I used to do what you did. I used to be a producer, a television producer, a writer, and a news writer and documentary producer, and then I went on and into, I went through news. I spent 20 years in news.
Goodness.
See, so there's who knows where you end up.
No, but you've got a British accent because we're born in London.
I know you are. Yes, I can tell.
How come you ended up in Hollywood?
I came over here some time ago for the day and stayed 30 years. And so I do still have a British accent. But Charlotte and I are both from Wales. And we were both born in Cardiff in the same hospital. She was born before me.
So what's the hardest lesson that you've learned being in this business?
Well, it's no hard lessons. I mean, the nice thing about Hollywood is that everybody fails in Hollywood. I mean, you're always going to eventually, a movie isn't going to work, something isn't going to work, and the town is very generous. As long as you've been collaborative and enthusiastic and that you have a decent reputation, the town embraces you when things go wrong. So it's a much more generous community on the inside than probably appears from the outside because it's seen as somewhat cutthroat. But there's a lot of charity money given here and a lot of contributions. And if you look around this event later, you'll see a lot of senior executives. In many cases when we do these dinners, the only senior executive who shows up is the one who gets the award. You know, I've already seen Ron Meyer, the head of Universal, and I've seen Joe Roth, who's head of Revolution, and that's only in the last 5 minutes. So that's a testament to the power of this event.
So what is your vision for Sony?
Well, Sony is a multi-layered company. As you know, we own an Indian cable channel, a very successful Indian cable channel.
I know.
And we make electronic products and music and movies, and tying them all together so that devices all over the world can bring you movies or music. And at some point down the road, in the smallest town in the most distant part of India, we'll be able to bring movies direct by satellite to individual receivers. So I think our job is to get entertainment that educates and amuses and enlightens and thrills to all parts of the world. And we can do that as devices get more sophisticated. Don't have to rely on cable television or whatever. So I think in the grand scheme of things, the content that we have will eventually cheer up a lot more people than it does now.
So you're going to use technology to make a difference on the planet?
To drive, yes, I think so, to both inform, educate, and entertain. And there's not much more fun than you can have than that. I mean, it's in the end. And it works two ways. I mean, Bollywood will come to us if we go to them.
Oh, but guess what? We are the only company in Hollywood who is the pipeline to that market. We have all the families. Our show is prime time. It's 3 times a week, and we have the relationships in Hollywood and Bollywood.
Oh, I'm sure you do.
So
why
we're opening
the
doors.
Greatest filmmaking nation in the world, for God's sake. Why wouldn't you be?
The purpose is to unite the world.
Yes.
So everybody gets healed, affected, enlightened.
It's a two-way communication. Everybody listens to each other. It's not us delivering content to the world. It's us exchanging content with the world. And in a perfect world, when devices are everywhere, that's what we'll all be able to do. And it'll bring us all together with a bit of luck.